I don't wanna work, cause I work so hard. I just need to unwind. Aloha everyone, I'm Kuhea Parakwelis, and thanks for joining us for today's Kuhea Show. I'm here with Nicole McMullen, who is Executive Director of the Bailey House Museum here in Wailuku, Maui. And thanks for joining us. Welcome.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
Yeah, you know, the Bailey House Museum is such a fascinating place. I've been there a couple of times and taken a bunch of young people who surprisingly are so fascinated as well. Usually, you know, students and young people are just kind of, you know, not very interested in museums, but the Bailey House Museum really captured their attention. So, you know, the Bailey House Museum has a very long history, so can you give us a very brief description of the Bailey House?
Sure, I'd be happy to. And what you said about the students, I think everyone's surprised when they come. They might expect to see some missionary pictures and things, but really our focus, our highlight is Hawaiian history and Hawaiian artifacts. So,
well, tell us about the Bailey family.
Sure, I'd be happy to. And the Bailey family, their story is quite fascinating. They came here in 1840 to teach Hawaiian girls that were studying at the area of the Bailey House. It was once a school for Hawaiian girls, and they came here to teach there and ended up living there after the school closed and became their family home. Mr. Bailey, Edward Bailey and Caroline Bailey were teachers, and he did lots of other interesting things with his life here.
Mm-hmm. And so the Bailey House Museum is a nonprofit here in Maui, and so what is the mission of the organization now?
Well, another thing people might not understand is our parent organization is the Maui Historical Society, so that's the nonprofit. And then the Maui Historical Society runs the Bailey House Museum, as well as a full research archive in the lower level, and the gardens. That's mainly what we do. And then the mission of the Historical Society is to collect, preserve, study, interpret, and share the history and heritage of Maui.
Mm-hmm. And that is your background as well, where you had your training.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Where did you go to school?
I went to school on the East Coast in Pennsylvania and studied for museum work, and I was a museum curator and collections manager out there.
Mm-hmm. So how do you find Hawaii as a place to work as, you know, somebody is that type of field?
Sure. Well, it's a fascinating, I mean, the history is so rich here and so varied, the cultures. And it's a wonderful place to be and live. And it's very different from the East Coast, but it's a beautiful place. And it's there aren't that many museums on Maui, unfortunately, even though there is such a rich history.
The Bailey House Museum, or the Bailey House, was formerly a school for Hawaiian girls, and today you're continuing some of that tradition by offering workshops and classes, and can you tell us more about that?
Sure, yes, we try to offer classes and programs throughout the year for the community and for visitors to Maui. We have classes in Hawaiian arts over the summer. Right now, lahala making. We've done kapa making. We have other programs, events, lectures, in order to create an awareness of history, Maui's history, for people.
Yeah, that's great. And I noticed on the grounds that you have a stage or what looks maybe like a hula paw. Mm-hmm. So do you have events right there on the
grounds? We do. We often do. We do have performances there, and it is a really lovely stage, hula stage area. And also, it's in our native plant garden, which was just recently, last summer, redone. Mm-hmm. So if people haven't seen it yet, I recommend coming and seeing our native plant garden and taking a tour of it.
So how many visitors do you have every year?
Roughly around 10,000.
That's a lot, quite a few. Mm-hmm. And do you have a lot of school children that come through classes?
We do. I'd like to have more. I'd like to bring all the schools at some time. But we get mostly fourth graders who are studying Hawaiian history. Right. That's really the focus of our tours. But we do have many other resources, especially in the archives, for all areas of Maui's history, all eras.
And you have a nice gift shop, and I noticed you sell a lot of products, and some have the Bailey House Museum label on them, and they all promote Hawaiian culture and history, and this book, for example.
Mm-hmm. Yes, this book is just came out last year, and it's a wonderful book about Edward Bailey, and it really tells the rich story of his life and the things he did to to help Maui and Maui's people through his teaching and his work with as a surveyor and also his paintings. And the cover shows one of his paintings. He was a rich, talented artist and painted Maui in the early days.
So I can imagine as a nonprofit, especially in this economy, that it must be challenging to run a museum. So what are you doing to stay afloat, and how do you depend on public support, contributions?
Mm-hmm. Yes, it is difficult. We depend almost entirely on donations and our annual members. We don't get any government funding, so and visitors, and visitors to our shop. And we also, our beautiful gardens, we've actually started to rent them for weddings and other events, so it's a little side business, but if you're looking for an inexpensive and beautiful location for your wedding.
Are most of your classes free classes, or is there a fee for those?
There's a fee. Right now, we're currently in a lauhala making class, and it's a 6-week class with an expert weaver. Uh-huh. So there's a fee, but everyone just is having a wonderful time.
It's really important to keep those practices alive, and you only do that by being able to learn from somebody who knows the craft and carry it on. So thank you for doing that.
Oh, well, that's part of our mission.
So I imagine that you probably have a small staff and rely on volunteers?
We rely on volunteers on a daily basis. It's extremely important. Even running our museum and shop is done by volunteers, and we only have 2 full-time staff.
Mm-hmm. Are there any specific qualifications that a person needs to be able to volunteer there?
An interest in history and a willingness to learn. Mm-hmm. For our museum shop, we require some retail experience, but really we're just looking for friendly people wanting to share the history and culture of Hawaii with visitors.
Are there any ideas about how to expand the Bailey House Museum? I know in this economic climate it might be difficult to dream big, but yes, what's in the future for the museum?
Well, I think we do need to look at that. We're working on a strategic planning right now. Mm-hmm. And it's because we're small, and we do actively collect artifacts, documents. We have a full research library, thousands and thousands of things in the basement, as it were. So we'll have to look at more space and where we can have some more exhibit and classroom space.
Mm-hmm. So if somebody wants to volunteer or to teach a class maybe, how would they contact you?
They can give us a call. Our number is 244-3326, or visit our website. There's a lot of information about what we do, what we have, how to make an appointment to see the archives, if they visit our website, which is mauimuseum.org.
Okay, and give us the hours, the days of operation and hours again.
Sure, Monday through Saturday from 10 to 4.
Okay, and we're really glad that you're here doing what you're doing, and maybe it'll encourage other people to open music. And it's probably very hard to do that, but...
yes, I imagine so, but thank you so much for having me, and the Bailey House is still sort of a hidden gem, so people realize that we have exhibits and programs all year. We have a wonderful shop with Maui, made on Maui items, and our gardens. Right.
It absolutely is a gem. And check it out, Bailey House Museum. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Hopefully we can go to a 15-minute segment someday, because, man, I'm going to be helpful.